to match the stars, Dick Martin, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Didi Conn, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reber.
How do you do? How are you? Are you all right, too?
Okay.
That's splendid. And are you all right?
Uh-huh.
I'm wonderful.
You all look grand. Really beautiful. Well,
thank you. Some of us look a little better than others
right.
of us.
Beautiful.
He looks
now
like a deranged
okay.
monk.
All right, let's get over here and meet Gloria Cachet and Ida Smith. Yeah. Hello, ladies. How are you? Now, Gloria's a current champ. She's won a couple of games, got $300. She's being challenged by Ida. The first game they played ended in a tie. Then we played a tiebreaker, and that ended in a tie. Now we're in another tiebreaker. She's had her question and matched every celebrity. So that means you got to go to work and do the same thing, and we'll have another tiebreaker.
Oh, I
and
think
then
so.
Another. And two. Here we go. One. Bing. Boing. This is the other half of the tiebreaker. Gloria, think carefully before you respond. After the Titanic struck the iceberg, the captain decided to learn how to blank. After the Titanic struck the iceberg, the captain decided to learn how to blank. Good. All right. All right. Everybody ready? Yes. Put it in there. Here we go. Now, Gloria.
Yes.
After the Titanic struck the iceberg, the captain decided to learn how to...
Swim.
Swim. The first time one of you does not say swim, the game is over. She's looking for swimmers.
Well, I'm afraid it won't be me.
Swim, it
swim,
is.
Swim,
yes,
indeed.
You said swim.
I did say swim.
That's one for her. She needs five more swimmers.
Why, he's batting three or four for the whole week, isn't
that terrific?
I said swim.
That's two for her. Score 6-2. Charles?
You mean if I said to make frozen daiquiris, learn to...
The game would be over.
Well, of course it wouldn't be over.
Yes, she said swim. Score 6-3. Debbie?
No!
Come here, Debbie.
Didi, Didi. Do I call me Debbie? That's better. I'm sorry.
What's wrong? Drive or navigate. So that means Ida Smith, Quinn Dan, Swim, and Nick Stringer. Hang around over here for a minute. We got to talk to this lady and wish her well and hope she enjoys spending her money here that she won on Match Game 76 and will remember us. Gloria Cachet. Goodbye, my dear. Here it is, Ida, your first chance at a big money payoff here. We polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Bit blank. Now, the most popular answer that group gave will be worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the middle one, or second most popular one, you get $250, and then the third one gets you $100, and you can get a little help from our celebrities.
Richard?
Bitter honey.
Bitter honey. A bitter honey.
Brett.
I have two. Bit. Bit players.
Bit players is one.
Well,
right?
The other one wasn't so hot either.
Charles?
Bit by bit.
Bit by bit. So there they are. Bit players, bit by bit, and bit oh honey. Now, you might have a better idea that's occurred to you and want to submit that. No? One of those.
Bit of honey.
Bit of honey.
I think that's
going to go with Richard.
Candy bar.
That's a candy bar. Very famous candy bar. All right, bit of honey. Let's see if it's up there and where. That's the important question. Is it under the $100 number? Bits and pieces.
Oh, they had a cool crowd that
pieces.
Day.
Sand pieces, yeah.
Bit sand pieces.
Bit sand pieces. Got it in my teeth. It's stuck in a...
Bits of sand pieces.
Sand Pisces.
May we see the $250 number? Bit part. Yeah. That's what Brett play, I had in mind, a bit player, a bit part, something like that. All right, last chance for a bit of honey. Here is the $500 number. Bit of honey!
Congratulations, you got it. Very good. Okay.
You're up to $600. And more important, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Whom do you call on over there to try and collect that amount of money?
Richard.
All right, Richard, get your ESP going. Think about this, little lady, would you, Richard? Get your ESP
going. I've done nothing else for the last 10 minutes,
Jane. Oh, I see.
I'm getting excited.
Okay, my dear. Let's see. It's in the laps of the gods now.
No, Richard.
Oh, and Richard. It's in the laps of Richard now. Here we go. Worth $5,000. County blank. County blank. That's C-O-U-N-T-Y blank. Now he's finished. Ida, tell us what answer you want to give us that'll match his. County
line.
County line. County line, turn and face your accuser. County line, he says, will match you for $5,000. What do you say?
There's a lot. County line, county jail. I say county fair.
County fair is a very good answer.
San Bernardino have a big one.
County fair. Yeah, I hadn't thought of that, but that is quite good. County Cork. Yes. Oh, there are a number of good ones here. Ida, you're up to $600, and a little bit later you're going to meet another player, but right now we've got this message for our viewers. Hello. Hello there. Are you ready to give a brisk round of applause to our new player, Mr. Craig Kincaid? Hello there.
Hello.
Now, Craig, we'd like to find out a little bit about you, where you're from and all that.
I live in Manhattan Beach, and I recently married, like to surf and ski a lot.
Yeah?
Work in a hardwood lumber company.
Okay. You do downhill?
Sure.
Okay.
You do uphill?
In the chair.
You do windows?
In the chair.
Exactly.
You do windows. You do. Okay. Good luck to Craig Kincaid. We'll begin by asking you to make a selection.
Well, my middle initial is B.
All right. B it is. Craig B. Kincaid.
B for Barry.
The Godfather said,
"Oh, with dialect."
Said, "We just spent Christmas Eve at Vito's house. We didn't hang mistletoe, instead we hung blank.
We just spent Christmas Eve at Vito's house.
Who is Vito, darling?
It's a friend of the Godfather. Someone connected with the Godfather. Just spent Christmas Eve at Vito's house. We didn't hang mistletoe, instead we hung blank. Go to work, dummy.
Darling, you mustn't. I'm an heiress. You have to keep that in mind.
Doesn't she look smashing today with that
waistcoat? It's my macho suit.
Yeah, it's really beautiful.
My macho suit. My Burt Reynolds suit.
This is a very easy one.
It is? Sure it is. I'm just trying to figure out some clever way to put
look at it. Now. Just look at it.
I got it. I love my answer.
Yeah.
What's the matter? Craig. Don't you have no taste?
Godfather said,
"I just spent Christmas Eve at Vito's house. We didn't hang mistletoe. Instead, we hung
spaghetti."
You don't know the Godfather.
That's Manhattan Beach.
You see the movie?
Sure.
Oh, all right. What do you say?
I said they hung Vito.
Right! See, Craig, we tried to inject a touch of humor into the proceedings here.
You do understand now, don't you? Yes, now I...
All right, Craig. What?
I don't care what anybody says. I still like my answer. I said we hung each other.
Well, that's good, too.
Very good.
That's acceptable. Charles?
Actually, it was they hung Vito's wife, Filomena.
Filomena. La bella ragazza. La bella donna. What do you say?
Vito.
Vito is the answer. No.
Well, there were many good answers.
There were good
answers.
Sure,
good.
Not to mention the obvious.
The obvious?
I told you not to mention that.
I'm sorry.
Vito.
Vito was the
always
answer.
Work. Always work.
What?
The former Mrs. Vito.
The former Mrs. Vito. That's a good one. He was looking for spaghetti and he got none. Now, a little pasta for zoo, but no spaghetti. Ida, you ready?
Yeah.
Hey.
What?
Hear about new Gidget movie?
No.
Oh. Want to hear about it?
Yeah.
I love Gidget movies.
You love Gidget movies?
Oh, I thought you said midget movies.
No, Gidget.
Oh, no, I don't like Gidget.
Come on.
I like the little people.
Well, I'm going to tell you about it anyway.
Oh, okay. I'm a big part.
In this Gidget movie, in this one, she's 102 years old. It's called Gidget Gets Blank. 102 years old. Gidget Gets Blank. Your imagination is running away with you.
Right. Now take that to the bank teller.
Okay. You have you written something yet?
No.
Now don't get excited just because I'm a man.
Wait a minute.
I'm waiting. I don't feel there's any pressure on you, Didi. Nope. Oh, look at those teeth. Don't they look real? Wow. All right. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Ida, did you hear about the new Gidget movie?
No.
Well, I'm going to tell you about it. I've come to the right place. In this one, she's 102 years old. It's called Gidget Gets Blank.
Old.
Old?
Old.
Do you remember what I just said to him?
I remember, yes. I was thinking hard so you wouldn't say it to me.
Tried to do it with a touch of a modicum of humor here. Oh, my dear. All right. What do you say?
I said that Gidget got very wrinkled.
All right. What happened to you?
Well, the last Gidget movie I saw was called Gidget Gets the Pill. But then after that, she got glasses.
Gidget gets glasses. At 102?
Drank right out of a bottle.
Until then.
I told you not to mention it.
I told you not to. What do you say, Charles?
Gidget gets hard arteries.
Oh! Oh! Atherosclerosis, get thee behind me. Now, Didi, what do you say?
I saw the same movie. Gidget gets the pill, and then after about 102 years old, the pill wore off, and she got pregnant.
Yay! Right. Gidget gets pregnant at the age of 102?
Yeah. Why not?
Subtitle, the film is just unlucky, I guess.
Yes.
Well, I saw the film. It's an excellent film.
It is.
Yeah, she gets run over by a dune buggy. Well, Gidget gets aroused.
At 102, eh? Okay. Now we come to Patti.
Who's counting?
Patti?
At 102. Gidget gets lucky late in life.
Gidget gets lucky late in life. All right, so there you are. There's round one. No score so far, but don't worry. We're going downhill from here. So hurry up and come back. Ready? Here we go. Round two coming up. A or B, Craig?
B.
B, I caught you by surprise, didn't I? Your mic was off. Say it again.
B.
Okay. Ready?
Yep.
Ready.
Yep.
Go. Go ahead, write your answers. Tex. He says veto. Tex, the Texas millionaire, said, well, I'm so rich, I have two swimming pools. One to swim in and one to blank in. That's how rich I am. I am rich. Here we go. Ready, ready, ready. Craig, Tex, the Texas millionaire, said, I'm so rich, I have two swimming pools. One to swim in and one to blank in.
Bathe.
Bathe. Okay. Bathe.
Interesting.
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 Weird.
No, he is richer than that.
He is.
Yes, he's so rich he uses one to fish in.
One to fish in. One to swim in, one to fish in.
Yes.
Yes?
We don't swim in your john, so don't you tinkle in our pool.
Oh. One to swim in, one to tinkle in. Charles?
Wet.
Wet. All right.
Oh.
Craig, are you catching on now? All right.
A lot of answers here.
Yeah, a lot of different answers. Yeah. What'd you say, Didi?
I said bathe.
Bathe!
Quack? Yes, yeah. What'd you say?
Tinkle.
Tinkle, tinkle, little star. Hello.
That scan's better than Wiz.
Wiz, yes. Wiz. Well, her son does that a lot, tinkle. You see. Yeah. Now, I don't. You know what you have to do? Big chore. Big chore. One to tie, two to win, right? Okay, here we go. Now, all of you here, gathered in this room on this day, know about Grauman's Chinese Theater, where the stars put their footprints in cement. You're all familiar with that? Well, they just opened up a delicatessen next door. The stars go there and put their footprints in blank. You understand? No?
If somebody doesn't do something about that music, I'm going to kill myself.
I tell you what, if you all write your answers quickly, we will hear less of that.
Hurry up!
Attaboy, yes, sir! Everybody march around the breakfast table with Don McNeil.
Don McNeil!
Yeah. Okay, everybody ready over there. Now, I'm going to give it to you slowly. You know about Grauman's Chinese Theater, where the stars put their footprints in cement? Well, they just opened up a delicatessen next door. The stars go there and put their footprints in blank.
In the potato salad.
In a potato salad. A delicatessen. Well, they do sell potato salad
in a
delicatessen.
I hope.
I don't know what kind of an impression you'd make with that, but let's try.
No, I would say it would be more logical that they would put their footprints in cream cheese.
Cream cheese. Little cream cheese sculpture there. Brett?
Obviously, Ida Smith did not change her name from something else. I said pastrami.
Pastrami? Okay. Charles?
I went with chopped liver.
Chopped liver is good. Very good. Ida Smith is looking for a little potato salad. Didi?
I was close with coleslaw.
Coleslaw? How would you do that? Put your foot in coleslaw? What'd you say?
Live chopper.
Chopped liver. You must match the redheaded lady to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Go ahead, redhead lady.
I said marinated herring and sour cream.
Marinated herring and sour cream, so Craig Kincaid wins the game. There you go. Funny, huh? Small world. Well, Ida, you will not leave here empty-handed. I'm happy about that.
Thank you.
$600 for Ida Smith, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye, my dear.
Thank you.
Craig, you got $100. Let's see how much more you're going to win here with the Big Money Super Match. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Let's blank. $500 if you match the answer they gave most often. $250 for the second most popular response and $100 for the third. Whom do you call on?
Didi.
Didi, what do you say? Fill in that blank. Let's blank. And just give us an oral response.
Bleh. Let's go out.
Let's go out? I don't mind if you do. Where do you want to go? What do you say? Another one?
Richard.
Let's make a deal.
Yeah.
Let's make a deal.
Charles.
Let's go.
Wait a minute, honey.
Now, Charles.
That's nice.
Say one, Charles, please. Charles, please say one.
All right, look.
Say
it,
please.
You know, man.
Thank you.
Let's dance.
Okay. Let's dance. Let's go out. Let's make a deal. You want one of those?
Make a deal.
Let's make a deal. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response. Let's dance, Benny Goodman's old theme song.
Thank you.
Let's see if Let's Make a Deal is under the $250 number. Let's go. That's part of Dee Dee's number. Now, last chance for Let's Make a Deal. Here's the $500 number. Make a deal. Okay. Congratulations to you. We've got to stop right now here at this point and do a little business with America. And this is it. Pay attention. You were all wonderful. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for these terrific celebrities.
Avery Schreiber. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Nancy Colt. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Dillivant.
Goodbye from Match Game 76.
Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Didi Conn, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers!
How do you do? How are you? Are you all right, too?
Okay.
That's splendid. And are you all right?
Uh-huh. I'm wonderful.
You all look grand. Really beautiful. Well,
thank you. Some of us will look a little better than others of us.
Beautiful.
He looks like a deranged monk.
All right, let's get over here and meet Gloria Cachet and Ida Smith. Yeah. Hello, ladies. How are you? How are you? Now, Gloria's a current champ. She's won a couple of games, got $300. She's being challenged by Ida. The first game they played ended in a tie. Then we played a tiebreaker, and that ended in a tie. Now we're in another tiebreaker. She's had her question and matched every celebrity. So that means you got to go to work and do the same thing, and we'll have another tiebreaker.
Another.
And two. Here we go. One. Bing. Boing. This is the other half of the tiebreaker. Gloria, think carefully before you respond. After the Titanic struck the iceberg, the captain decided to learn how to blank. After the Titanic struck the iceberg, the captain decided to learn how to blank. Good. All right. All right. Everybody ready? Yes. Put it in there. Here we go. Now, Gloria.
Yes.
After the Titanic struck the iceberg, the captain decided to learn how to...
Swim.
Swim. The first time one of you does not say swim, the game is over. She's looking for swimmers.
Well, I'm afraid it won't be me.
Swim, it is.
Swim,
yes,
indeed.
You said swim.
Did say swim.
That's one for her. She needs five more swimmers.
Why, he's batting three or four for the whole week, isn't it?
Terrific.
I said swim.
That's two for her. Score 6-2. Charles?
You mean if I said to make frozen daiquiris, learn to...
The game would be over.
Well, of course it wouldn't be over.
Yes, she said swim. Score 6-3. Debbie?
No!
Come here, Debbie.
Didi. Do I call me Debbie? That's better. I'm sorry.
What's wrong? Drive or navigate. So that means Ida Smith, who's the name? Swim and mix drinks. Come on down, Ida. Well, hang around over here for a minute. We got to talk to this lady and wish her well and hope she enjoys spending her money here. She won on Match Game 76 and will remember us. Gloria Cachet. Goodbye, my dear. Here it is, Ida, your first chance at a big... Let's see. It's in the laps of the gods now.
No, Richard.
Oh, and Richard. It's in the laps of Richard now. Here we go. Worth $5,000. County... blank. County blank. That's C-O-U-N-T-Y blank. Now he's finished. Ida, tell us what answer you want to give us that'll match his. County.
Line.
County line. County line, turn and face your accuser. County line, he says, will match you for $5,000. What do you say?
There's a lot, county line. County jail, I say county fair.
County fair is a very good answer.
San Bernardino have a big one.
County fair, yeah, I hadn't thought of that, but that is quite good. County Cork, yes. Oh, there are a number of good ones here. Ida, you're up to $600, and a little bit later you're going to meet another player, but right now we've got this message for our viewers. Hello, hello there. Are you ready to give a brisk round of applause to our new player, Mr. Craig Kincaid? Hello there. Now, Craig, we'd like to find out a little bit about you, where you're from and all that.
I live in Manhattan Beach, and I recently married, like to surf and ski a lot.
Yeah?
Work in a hardwood lumber company.
Okay, you do downhill?
Sure.
Okay.
In the chair.
You do windows?
In the chair.
Exactly.
You do windows. Okay, good luck to Craig Kincaid. We'll begin by asking you to make a selection.
Well, my middle initial is B.
All right. B it is. Craig B. Kincaid.
B for Barry.
The Godfather said,
oh, a dialect.
Said,
we just spent Christmas Eve at Vito's house. We didn't hang mistletoe. Instead, we hung blank. Just spent Christmas Eve
at Vito's house.
Vito.
We didn't veto.
Who is Vito, darling?
It's a friend of the Godfather.
Oh.
Someone connected with the Godfather. Just spent Christmas Eve at Vito's house. We didn't hang mistletoe. Instead, we hung blank. Go to work, dummy. Oh.
Darling, you mustn't. I'm an heiress. You have to keep that in mind.
Doesn't she look smashing today with that
waistcoat? It's my macho suit.
Yeah, it's really beautiful.
My macho suit. My Burt Reynolds suit.
All right. This is a very easy one.
It is? Sure it is. I'm just trying to figure out some clever way to put it.
Look at it now. Just look at it.
I got it. I love my answer.
Yeah.
What's the matter? Don't you have no taste?
Godfather said,
I just spent Christmas Eve at Vito's house. We didn't hang mistletoe. Instead, we hung...
spaghetti.
You don't know the Godfather.
That's Manhattan Beach.
You see the movie?
Sure.
Oh, all right. What do you say?
I said they hung Vito.
See, Craig, we tried to inject a touch of humor into the proceedings here.
I see.
Do understand now, don't you?
Yes, now I...
All right, Craig. What?
I don't care what anybody says. I still like my answer. I said we hung each other.
Well, that's good, too.
Very good.
That's acceptable. Charles?
Actually, it was they hung Vito's wife, Filomena.
Filomena, la bella ragazza, la bella donna. What do you say?
Vito.
Vito is the answer. Now, money payoff here. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Bit blank. Now, the most popular answer that group gave will be worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the middle one, their second most popular one, you get $250. And then the third one gets you $100, and you can get a little help from our celebrities.
Richard?
Bitter honey.
Bitter honey. A bitter honey.
Brett.
I have two. Bit players.
Bit players is one,
well,
right?
The other one wasn't so hot either.
Charles?
Bit by bit.
Bit by bit. So there they are. Bit players, bit by bit, and bit of honey. Now... you might have a better idea that's occurred to you and want to submit that. No? One of those.
Bit of honey.
Bit of honey.
I'm
going to go with Richard.
That's
a candy bar. Very famous candy bar. All right, bit of honey. Let's see if it's up there and where. That's the important question. Is it under the $100 number? Bits and pieces.
Oh, they had a cool crowd that
pieces.
Day.
Sand pieces. Sand pieces, yeah.
Sand pieces.
Bit sand pieces. Got it in my teeth. It's stuck in a...
it's a sand piece of
sand Pisces.
May we see the $250 number? Bit part. Yeah. That's what Brett had in mind, a bit player, bit part, something like that. All right, last chance for a bit of honey. Here is the $500 number. Bit of honey!
Congratulations, you got it. Very good.
Okay. Well, Ida, you're up to $600. And more important, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Whom do you call on over there to try and collect that amount of money?
Richard.
All right, Richard. Get your ESP going. Think about this, little lady, would you, Richard? Get your ESP going.
I've done nothing else for the last 10 minutes,
Oh, I see.
I'm getting excited.
Okay, my dear.